Hello everyone, welcome back. My name is Sun, founder and CEO of Global Quality Assurance Company. Welcome to our LQA channel. Our channel is out of sharing information about the hardware and software testing. So to see more helpful video, please subscribe to us. Years ago, I came to know about some testing concept and I think it's very important. So today I want to share you one concept named the test level. So let's get started. Have you ever heard about the wind motors? As you can see on our picture, there are four testing levels are ordered from the bottom to the top. Those are the unit testing, integration testing, system testing and acceptance testing. Why do you need to distinguish those testing levels? Because we can understand specific objective of each level. You can integrate it effectively using them to improve the qualities. Following the timeline, we start with the unit testing. Unit testing, as known component testing, is to verify the functional and non-functional behavior of the module in the system. Normally, the programmer will do the unit testing by isolating their module from the rest of the system. They can do this manually or automatically by using the tool named the unit or an unit. The developer will, based on detailed design, to check their code data structure of the database in order to find out if there is any data flow problem or any incorrect code. After finishing the unit testing, we go to the integration testing. Integration testing is to verify functional and non-functional of the interface between the component or system integration. So there are two types of the integration. The first one is the component integration testing will be done by the programmer, and the system integration testing might be done by the independent testing team. So depending on each time, the input, the output, and the system and the test might be different, but the objective seems to be the same. We focus on the integration between the component of the system. And the next step is the system testing. System testing is focusing on the behavior and the capabilities of the whole system, whole products, as an end-to-end usage. Independent testing team typically carry out the system testing and they will set up the testing environment is very similar to the production one. They will produce a testing report which can be used by the stakeholder in order to make the release decision. The typical defects could be missing requirement or any incorrect functionalities of the system. The last level is acceptance testing. Acceptance testing is similar to the system testing. It will focus on the behavior and also the capabilities of the whole system, the whole product. But it differs from the system test. It will produce the information to accept the system readiness for deployment and use by the end user. Finding the bug is not the objective of the acceptance test because it will be too late if you found the defect at this stage. The acceptance testing is the responsibilities of the customer, business user, product owner, and also the operator of the system. Normally, there are four common forms of the acceptance testing, including the user acceptance testing, the operational acceptance testing, the contractual and regulator acceptance testing, and the last one is the alpha and beta testing. So, those are very important for testing level. At the beginning of the project, all stakeholders, including the product owner, the project manager, and also the quality assurance manager, should sit together and to plan how to handle those four levels in the project to ensure that the product and the software will meet the business need and also the user requirement. Otherwise, the product or the system will not fit to use. So if you want to see the video, please subscribe to us and also hit on the bell to receive the notification. Thank you for watching and see you soon.